By the end of this video, you're going to know how to build a coming soon page and be able to integrate a form to collect email addresses so that you can notify people about when something new is coming. We're going to build this using Card, a one-page website builder that we love here at No Code MBA. And we'll walk you through the entire process from choosing the right template to modifying the page, and then also how to integrate this with your email service provider. All right, let's get started. So the first step is to choose a starting point. And the best thing about Card, or one of the best features, is that it has all these great templates. So if we scroll down, we don't really see, or I can't see, a coming soon type of page. So what we're going to do is go back to the start, or to the top, click form, because it's a form, scroll down, and you'll see this one here. Now you can click demo to see what it's like, or just click select. Now, when we click select, it's going to be pro, because this is a pro template. And we talked about pricing before. It's very reasonable with Card at just $19 a year to host your own website. So it's custom domains, integrate forms, widgets, video uploads, these pro templates, no branding, etc. So it's actually a really good deal. And if we go select and start free trial, we've got this for 7 days. So we can play around with it until we are ready to go with this. So you have 7 days really to play around with it before you publish it. So here it is. Pretty cool. This is a coming soon page that has been created by Card and the template. But there's a few things we need to do with this. The first one, let's do the fun one first, the timer. So when you click timer, it's not going to be in 2017. It's going to be in, let's say, 24, November the 12th. Great. At that time, I'm going to do New York time, which is here, Eastern time. Click done. And then this should update once this is published to show you the countdown timer for this in terms of when something is coming soon. So that's the first step. The next step is to customize the visuals. Now, we won't do all of this right now, but we'll look into this in terms of going, clicking any element, text, and then you can change the text here and then the appearance here. So maybe you want a different font. Let's just go with outfit and make it really big like that. Click done. You can also click the back section, the background. You can use an image. You can also have different types of colors here as well. And you can choose gradients, which I like to do as well. So if you look at the gradient here, let's just say we're going to go with this one, which looks kind of cool, actually. And then the text over here, you can change the text, whatever it's going to be. You can add in images here. So let's say you want to have an image above the timer. Okay, what we can do is just add image, and it's added an image there. We could put an image in here. You can play around with this where you have different containers to have the image over here, the countdown timer over here. You can move the countdown timer up to the top if you prefer. So there's a lot you can do with this in order to modify it. It's all drag and drop, very simple to use, especially once you have a little play around with it in the beginning. Now, the main thing we need to do is to make sure that people are doing this. So we're going to put this up here above the image. And when we click on the form, what we can do is decide what kind of form it's going to be. So a sign-up form is one that's going to link to an email service provider. So we can choose with MailChimp, we can choose ActiveCampaign, MailerLite. Those are the main ones that I've used before. ConvertKit is popular now as well. Beehive is a new one that's really popular too. So this is like a way for you to connect. When people sign up here, it's going to connect, let's just say, to MailChimp. And then you can send them emails once it goes live. But you can also send them emails once they sign up. So this is sending an automation email once they sign up to this to say, welcome to our new product. It's coming soon. As you know, you are all signed up. We'll let you know when it's going to drop. We'll let you know all the details beforehand, etc. Now, to do all this, this is the technical side of things. So let's say if you're using MailChimp, I would just search MailChimp Card integration, and you'll get very clear instructions either from Card or from MailChimp or a different blog that allow you to really just go through this, put in your API key, audience ID, any tags that you want to add, how to do this on completion, etc. This is the technical side of things that can be frustrating, but all in all, once you have this set up, take a bit of time to do it, it's going to mean that this form here, when people enter their information, is going to go over to MailChimp or whichever service provider you're going to use. And then before you go live, let's say you've designed it all, what you want to do is click this button over here to make sure it's looking good on mobile. And I think that is looking fantastic on mobile. So you can see here that it's this big coming soon. You have the countdown timer, the text, enter your email address, a little picture here. And then this, what this means here is when it's done, it's going to say this. So once somebody has entered the email in, that's what's going to show up after. So it's quite a cool way to do it. And then a big thing to do is once you go publish over here, and let's just say you go live, and you publish to your custom domain, then what you can do is test it out. Test out the form to make sure that it's connected to your email service provider. Now, if you want to learn more about building with Card, then be sure to take a look at our playlist. I'll leave a link in the description. But if you want to really dive into how to use no-code tools to build websites, apps, and automations and more, then go to nocode.mba and take a look at our premium courses, where top no-code instructors are going to guide you through how to build using no-code tools. So thanks again for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.